After introducing single bus layouts, today we address hybrid layout of DC microgrids, where we provide and detail two types of them. The main learning objective will fall under three main questions. First, how a hybrid bus DC microgrid is created. Second, what are the main advantages and disadvantages of a hybrid layout. And third, what are the grid feeding and grid forming components in a hybrid layout. The first type of hybrid bus is shown on the slide. The hybrid layout typically consists of one or more DC links connected to the AC ones. In the figure, two AC-DC converters are placed between DC and DC buses. This is mainly to achieve a higher reliability in case of that of one of them falls to properly operate, and also to increase the power transfer capacity between AC and DC bus. The AC bus can mainly rely on the connection to the grid. However, when the grid is not available, the AC bus can be controlled either by the battery or backup diesel generator. At the DC bus, the photovoltaic solar is stepped up through a boost step-up converter. In a similar way, DC loads are also connected using a buck DC converter, as typically the voltage of DC link is higher than the one of the loads. An IGBT-based three-leg switches are used to connect AC loads to the DC link. At the AC bus, the diesel engine is directly connected to the bus, while the battery bank is connected through a three-phase, three-leg DC to AC inverter. The figure shows the representation of components based on the grid forming or grid feeding schemes. As it is shown, the voltage of DC bus can be solely controlled by the AC bus, as the photovoltaic unit, AC loads and DC loads themselves have limitations to maintain the DC link voltage. At the AC bus, if strong, the grid is typically the best choice to control the AC link voltage. However, if the grid is weak, then the battery bank or diesel generator can be used to regulate the AC voltage. As mentioned, to further increase the reliability, it is possible to create two AC buses where the diesel engine is seen as a backup for the DC bus. Thus, in the case of faults at AC utility mains or AC bus, still the DC bus can remain operational thanks to diesel through the another AC bus. The power generated by the diesel generator can effectively mitigate the intermittencies associated with wind and photovoltaic solar at DC bus, and can be exclusively and directly consumed by the loads connected to the DC bus. This might result in an increased efficiency where, particularly during high prices, the power generated by diesel is not first stored in the battery and then sent to the DC bus, avoiding charging and discharging efficiency of the battery. The wind generator is now connected through a diode bridge rectifier and provides more volatility and fluctuations on the DC bus. Again, in such a cases, the diesel engine can help mitigate power fluctuations imposed by the wind generator, and in general, from an economic point of view, it is also a challenge to control because, for example, when the prices of electricity are high with a peak load, the microgrid customer would rather use the power stored in the battery without buying it from the mains. This is also a way to see how financial aspects change control strategies like droop control in moments when a lot of solar availability, energy prices could be also negative because of the excess of production with respect to the demand. This is a scenario that in the future will be very often common. The figure on the slide illustrates the representation of components based on grid forming or grid feeding schemes. As it is shown, the voltage of DC bus can be controlled by the AC bus or diesel engine. Be reminded that the photovoltaic solar unit, AC loads and DC loads themselves have limitations to maintain the DC link voltage. As it is shown, the active power of diesel engine as grid feeding at the AC bus can be controlled in such a way that the DC link voltage fluctuations can be effectively mitigated by the diesel engine as a grid forming at the DC bus. Hybrid bus has many advantages, particularly compared to the single bus DC microgrid. First, These layouts are expandable, as the microgrid can be expanded in both DC and AC, where and when necessary. Also, due to the connection of AC and DC bus through fully controlled power converters, the control is more flexible. And finally, due to the presence of both AC and DC, various components can be connected in a more efficient way. For instance, DC loads are mainly connected to the DC link, while AC loads to the AC bus. This helps eliminate a lot of unnecessary AC-DC conversions, and as a result, the overall efficiency is improved. Despite all these advantages, the reliability and stability of the system is lower compared to the single bus layout with direct connection of the battery. Well, they highlighted two types of hybrid DC layouts. We addressed the advantages and disadvantages of each type and then compared them with a single bus layout. In the next video, we mainly focus on a bipolar single bus DC microgrid and close this week with a summary of voltage level.